this is National Library of Serbia EDM mapping experience. We decided to use Notepad++ as the text editor and its XML tools plugins, since they're simple, easy to use, and free. And since we didn't use any mapping tool or system that would generate XSLT code for the transformation, but we had personnel that would write XSL script, we decided to write the code from scratch. We used European data model mapping guidelines to see what fields and structure EDM data should have, and by following these guidelines, we were able to do it. The actual process of mapping looks somewhat like this. Since we were transforming our data that is in a file, usually a whole collection is in one file, we wrote the XSL introduces EDM structure from MARC and calls other matching templates for each EDM field. In short, one template that runs for each record and collection and calls other templates that get data from MARC record and place it in the EDM. So for each EDM element, there is a template that fills it with matching values from MARC data. Basically, the whole transformation process happens in Notepad. We load our MARC XML data into the Notepad, execute XSLT code for that data, and receive the output file, which is in the EDM data format. And that's it. The execution of the XSLT code happens with XSLT processor that comes with XML tools plugin for the Notepad that was previously mentioned. Of course, there were issues mostly with data fields which contain additional information that is not suited for EDM data fields. For example, sometimes the role of the contributor is given beside his name or the problem regarding dates, when there are words that explain the date. Those cannot be processed in the EDM data. There are many things like this that cannot be fixed automatically, because there is no pattern in which those characters or words may appear. And also fixing this would be altering the original data that was entered according to the cataloging rules. Another issue would be determining XML length attribute that is very important for the EDM. The problem is that in MARC there are dedicated data fields that contain information about the language of the actual object, text language, title language, etc., and information about the cataloging language that is language in which are information given by the cataloging person. In some cases, this should be enough to provide XML language attribute, but there are cases when cataloging person decides that some information should be given in text language and some in cataloging language. So in MARC there is no attribute of the data field element that says in which language the element value is given, unlike in the EDM. Maybe some language detection algorithms could be a solution for this problem, but it is questionable if this could be even implemented or could they even work precisely with the short text data. As for our recommendations, since we have never actually used any tool or system for mapping, it is hard to say which method is better. Surely writing the code gives more control and free space to the person that does the mapping to handle the data and enables the full use of XSLT capabilities, but we would still recommend using tools and systems designed for metadata mapping, aggregating, sharing, and such to the professionals that are not familiar with the XSLT coding.